In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create an e-commerce app using the MIT App Inventor. First of all, we need to click on the new project, and my project name is the cloth shopping. So you can see this is our first screen, okay? And in this screen, we are going to design our first screen, okay? It's a platform screen. So in the left side, you'll see the layout option. Click on this. So just close this and use the vertical arrangement and make this is hide end with this fill pattern. Same we do on all apps, okay? Click on the arrangement and make this hide. And now here you can use two things, like you can design, you can add the colors, or you can add the background picture that will look more attractive. Okay, so I'm going to add the background picture here. So first of all, I'm going to add here one button. So click on user interface and just drag and drop one button. And I'm going to add my brand logo also. So for that, I'm going to use here the image like this and click on vertical arrangement and make all the thing in a center. Okay, like this and like this. Now click on that button, or you can just say here shop now. And make this at least 20. Have some space between both, App Inventor should have the padding and margin option in their components. This is really important thing I feel till now. So let's remove that text and just make that text height is 5%. Like this. Click on shop now, or you can just change that to the black or something, default color, and make it text white. And I'm going to add your one background image. So click on vertical arrangement and just click on image, click on upload files, click on choose file. Now go to the desktop. I have one picture, okay, this one. So I'm going to just add this, open this, and let's see how this will look. Oh, that's a look amazing, right? But I need to add my logo image also. So click on this image and click on, make sure height should be like, 100 pixel or 50 pixel or something, because it's just a logo. So you can make it 100 or 50 pixel like this. And now let's click on the picture option, upload file, and again choose file. And add my own logo here. That's it. This is our first screen. Okay. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just hide this one. And I'm going to just add another arrangement, vertical arrangement, and click on layout and just drag and drop here the vertical scroll arrangement. This is important. Okay. And make sure that make it width and height is fill parent like this. And now let's go to the, just enable this. And as you can see here, just hide this one, scroll. You'll see here, this is the shop now. So whenever someone click on this, so we need to open the another screen, okay? So let's go to the block. And like button one, someone click on this. So we need to hide the current one, visual, false, like this. And we need to just open the scroll arrangement, make it visible on, okay? So our first screen will complete, like true. Okay, so finally, whenever someone click on the shop now button, so their first arrangement, it means the first screen will hide and another screen, vertical scroll arrangement, will open. Okay, let's go to the design, and you can see what people click on this shop now. When people click on shop now, that will hide and that will open. So that is our main shop page. Okay, now we need to create our shop page. So how we can do this? So it's really very simple. So in the left side, you will see here the horizontal arrangement. Drag and drop this. And make this with this fill parent. Okay, that should be with this fill parent. Like this. Now we need to drag and drop your one vertical arrangement again under that horizontal arrangement. Okay, and this is the vertical arrangement. Drag and drop this like this. Okay, now click on the user interface and make sure that vertical arrangement should be, height should be fill parent like this. Okay, and you can make that with this also fill parent like this. Now, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just drag and drop one image here, one label, and one more label, and one button. Okay, like this. Now, click on that image, and I'm going to add any product. So, click on the picture, click on upload files, click on choose file. I have some products, okay, that, okay, cat t-shirt, this one. Make sure that image should be, 100 or 50 pixel. Like, let me try the 100 pixel, how that will look. Oh, it's look fine, okay? In the label, you can see here, so you can just add the product name. So like, cute cat t-shirt, okay? Like this, make it font bold, like this. In the another label, you can just display the price. So like price is like, $16, like this. Whatever you want to add, font bold, or you can make that font italic or also like this. Okay, now make sure vertical arrangement should be in our center, like this. Alignment content and center, like this. Okay, Now change that button text to something by now, okay? By now. This is by now button. Make sure this is the 14 is fine. Make it font bold. Background color, you can choose. So I'm going to use here the color plate, okay? So that is really important thing, okay? So let's go here, just use that. So I love this color. Let's try some color plate. Okay, this one is fine. So I'm going to use here this color plate, okay? So for that, I'm going to just use that one color. And for the custom, I'm going to just paste it like this. And text color will be white. Like this, by now, okay? Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just copy and paste that vertical arrangement. Okay, just select this. Just use controls here, commands here, command three. Now we have two products, right? Now what we need to do, we just need to change the image, text and the pricing. So as you can see here, this is the image three. So I'm going to just click on upload file, choose file, and I'm going to add this one, cat image. Oh, sorry, this is a 1 MB image. I need to resize. Make sure the image size should be, around 50 KB or 100 KB or 200 KB. This one I'm going to just try. Okay, cool. Now we have two products. We have, t-shirt. So you can just say here, okay, it's like sleepy cat t-shirt. Price is around $20. Like this. Okay. Now we have two products. Now I'm going to change the background color of that vertical arrangement. Okay. So background color, I'm going to make go to the design and I'm going to use light color like this. Hello. And go to the custom, use that color. These two things you can do. You can add the multiple background color for the Apple product. So that make a difference when people see the products, or you can change the color in the horizontal arrangement. Okay. In the this horizontal arrangement. So you can try both. So let me just try the horizontal also. Like this, so that will look like this. And for that, like for the vertical arrangement, I'm gonna just say here none, okay, like this. And for the make sure that should be also the none. And this height, another arrangement, okay, that different color is also none, like this. Now we need to copy and paste the whole horizontal arrangement, okay. Now this copy and paste it. Now we have four product. Again copy. We have six products. As you can see, we have six products. You can add multiple products like this. We can connect our Google Sheet also to fetch the all product details here, because we already have learned how we can fetch the data from the Google Sheet using the MIT App Inventor. So you can do it here also. Now this is done. You can change the images. You can change the text, all the things. Now these are our products. So whenever you open app, because we are using the vertical scroll arrangement. So whenever someone open app, so we can see only the four apps, but when you scroll, so we can see the multiple products. Okay. Now what we need to do, and the main thing is how the people can buy. So once the people click on the buy now button, so we will redirect that user to our WhatsApp number, the owner WhatsApp number with that text. So we can contact them and we can deliver that product. Okay. So how we can do this? So for that, we need to use here some things like, we need to use their activity. So in the left side, you will see here the connectivity option, or just drag and drop that activity starter like this. Okay. Now let's go to the blog section. So first of all, let's see this buy now button name is this one. What? Not full. This one is this. This is button two. So whenever someone click on the button two, so we need to send the WhatsApp message. Okay. So we need to start the activity. Okay. So first of all, before starting the activity, we need to set the activity. So for that, we need to open the WhatsApp and we need to send the message. So how we can do this? So here's one thing is WhatsApp URL send text. Okay. Now we can see here's a option like use https wa.me, then WhatsApp phone number. You need to put your phone number, question mark, text equal your code or your text. I'm going to just copy whole thing like this. Okay. Here. And I'm going to use your one text field like this. Paste it here. Now what I need to do here, I need to add my number here. Okay. So you can add your number here. So I'm going to just add my number, suppose. And this is the text field. Okay. So text field, I'm going to add, I want to buy this $16 what is the cost for that product that we have added? $16 first product, okay? And what you can do, you can add, assign the values or assign the any unique number to the product. And whenever someone click on that buy now, so you can receive that unique number only. So you will know that what's the product customer needed. Now we need to call this. So how we can call this? So first of all, what I need to do here, we need to call here Android view. So first thing is like, you know, go to the activity and you will see the option of set action, this one. Call it here like this. Okay. Now, after the action, what action we need to add? So simply just use the any text field like this, call this here, Android dot intent dot action dot view. Okay, that we need to write. Then we need to call the same again like action, and you will see here the set started activity. So you can just call it here, okay, like same. But in the action, you can add here the data URI, this it. And the data URI is this. Simple, okay? Now we need to start that activity. So click on activity starter and you can see the start activity. Call it here, simply like this, simple. Now people will open this. Once the people go button click on two, then they will redirect to our WhatsApp number. Now same thing we need to do for the all the products, right? So like copy paste all the things like this. Okay, now this is the code. Now you can just change the button name to 3 and this button is button 4. You can add multiple buttons, and all the multiple button, we know that which button have the that product. So if suppose the third button have the product called $20, so you need to change here the text. So $20 like this. And that's the overall your shopping app, simple. Now, whenever go to the design, whenever someone open this, so make sure what you need to do here, we need to scroll and should be visible off, and you know, this should be on like this. So this is our app. So whenever someone open, people open an app, they will click on the shop now, they will redirect to our product page, and they once they click on the button one, so they can redirect to our WhatsApp number, okay? And it's really simple, but amazing and fantastic to start your own e-commerce app with the help of MIT App Inventor. And it's really easy. You don't need to pay any server cost or nothing at all. So thank you so much, okay? So let me show you the demo how this will look, okay? Shop now, okay? Now let's click on that button. And now you will see the products here. As you can see, that t-shirt price $10. But again, 12 for the boys, like cute cat t-shirt for $15, $25. All these are the products, okay? Now let's buy someone. So let's buy, try to buy a first one. Let's click on the buy now. And that will redirect you to their owner WhatsApp. So as you can see, I want to buy cute cat t-shirt $10. You can just send them like this. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.